The placebo effect is so weird. I mean, how does the power of placebo even work? Is it all in your head? Well, new research suggests it might be all in your genes. Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. The placebo effect fascinates me. I mean, how could a sugar pill heal somebody with just the power of belief? This effect is probably the basis for a lot of ancient medicine, where spells, powders, and rituals ruled the day. A lot of pomp and circumstance would certainly convince most people of the power of the medicine. But it's not just in the past. Even today, most doctors admit to prescribing a placebo. I mean, antibiotics for a cold? Really? But doctors aren't dumb, they're just trying to make you feel better. Maybe just going to the doctor, being in a doctor's office, the whole shebang, can make you feel better, just like a healing ritual would have done thousands of years ago. Even if it is just all in your head. But in some cases, even knowing it's a placebo doesn't change the outcome. One study published in PLOS ONE found that even if researchers say this is a sugar pill and write placebo on the bottle, the patients reported improvement in their symptoms. So it really does seem like the doctor-patient relationship has a lot to do with it. But while placebos might seem like a magical cure, not everyone is susceptible to the effect. In a review published in the journal Trends in Molecular Medicine, researchers from Beth Israel Deaconess Medical Center and from Brigham and Women's Hospital introduced the idea of a placebome, or the idea that your genes affect whether or not the placebo effect will work on you. This could explain decades of strange results with placebos. Not everyone responds to them. Most research suggests that placebos improve health in both subjective and objective measures in about 30 to 40% of people. While that's still not most people, that's a pretty large percentage. One of the first studies to suggest a genetic link was published in 2008 in the journal Neuroscience. The study found that placebos, in the case of a sugar pill, worked in treating anxiety in 40% of the trial participants who got it. The researchers found that those who took the sugar pill had decreased activity in the amygdala, suggesting that the placebo worked through the same mechanisms as the active drug in the trial. The study also analyzed genes that regulate serotonin in the brain. The researchers found that only people with certain alleles or types of genes had that regulation of activity in the amygdala. In another study in 2012, one of the researchers from the Beth Israel Deaconess Medical Center found a specific gene which acts on dopamine in the brain. She found that people with a different version of the gene responded differently to placebos. Maybe because people with a different gene variant have different levels of dopamine available in the prefrontal cortex. Dopamine has been implicated in the confirmation bias feeling. So maybe people with this gene expect the drug to work, so they look for confirmation of this expectation. So even if they're getting a sugar pill, the soothing words of the doctor confirms their expectation that the drug will work. It'll certainly be an interesting area of research to keep an eye on, and it raises a lot of issues. It suggests that placebos run through the same neurotransmitters as drug responses, which could have a huge impact on the way we research drugs. Do placebos and drugs interact? Should drug trials always include a no treatment group? I don't know, we'll have to keep an eye on it. So what do you think? If placebos work, are they really that bad? Sound off down in the comments below. While you're at it, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here. We've got new episodes every day of the week.